it's Charles Folkart on September 13, 2017. Welcome, viewers and subscribers and supporters of this channel. This video is on MGTOW, men going their own way. And I want to give you a little background as to why I think I'm qualified to speak on this. But before I do, I want to mention that this is a video, kind of a follow-up video on one that I made several months ago, where I said I wanted to talk about the MGTOW and where I think the MGTOW movement is going wrong, is going astray, and it's going to be, it's not good. It's not good for the white race. And I know MGTOW is pretty successful. You got a lot of guys out there just because they're telling men what they want to hear. And guys like me and the message I have is not going to be very popular because, one, most men, a lot of men don't give a rat's behind for scripture. And they want to hear what they're being told. But my background is such that I have every reason to be a MGTOW man, and I understand where the men are coming from, and I want to give you a very condensed synopsis as to the effect that women have had in my life, the cost that I've paid because of the feminization of our females, of the women in our race, and how the legal system is no more a justice system. It is a justice system, but you're not one of the us if you're not a female and you're not in the club. It's a legal system, is what it is, and this legal system is hammering us white men, white males, and you females, you white females, better get a clue pretty quick because it's going to ruin the entire race. And I want to give you some background on myself and in my history as to why why I'm qualified to talk on the subject of MGTOW. Let's start with my childhood in a suburb of Detroit, Michigan, shall we? Alrighty, that's me there in the striped shirt. This is circa 1960. I was about 8 or 9 years old at this time. You can tell I'm having a good time. These are my buddies. That's Tommy and Tony or Anthony. We built this go-kart. I remember building this go-kart, and this is actually, it was my go-kart. We're at my house. This is our driveway. My father was a building contractor. He built our house. It was a 4-bedroom with a full basement, a big garage out in the back what was eventually probably going to end up being a hangout in the back of the shop on the second floor, looked out over the back of our property. We had another 100 yards behind our property all the way to a creek. I got to roam all around, you know, 1950s, early 1960s outside of Detroit. My father allowed me to go all over the place. The only rule I had is don't get yourself in trouble and obey what he said and be home before the street when the street lights went on. And as you can see here, it was a pretty good life. I think I was a pretty happy boy. But my mother and father, for some reason, couldn't work it out. They had a troubled marriage. And my mother, when I was about 10, and my younger brother was about 6, and my youngest brother was about 2, she packed us all up in this 1955 Chevy Bel Air there. I remember it as I remember my dad making a box that fit in the back trunk. Have hit the carpenters build this box that fits in the back of the truck for our stuff. And we went down Route 66 all the way to the Los Angeles area, Southern California, to live with her parents. And the word was my father was going to come later, and that never happened. But the point I want to make is my mother was a stay-at-home mom, and for one reason or the other, she couldn't work it out with my dad, and that had an effect. Her leaving my dad and getting a divorce affected me for my entire life. And some of you women, in fact, all of you women, you should take into account very, very seriously what's going to happen with you getting a divorce, what the effect is going to be on your children. And a lot of you women don't take that enough into consideration. Okay, so now here we are, three boys with a single mom living in Southern California. My dad never shows up. Now we've got to make it on our own. My mother is not making very much. We're broke. We're basically lower middle class. And I remember seeing my mother sit there many, many, many times when she was working, driving into Los Angeles, got a low-paying job there in Los Angeles, driving home, worked up at 6 o'clock in the morning, home at 6 o'clock. She's tired. And I saw her sitting there many, many times, deep in thought. She was probably thinking, you know, what the hell did I do? We never talked about it. She never wanted to talk about what happened. But I have a pretty good idea what happened, folks, because the same thing ended up happening to me. So anyway, so that affected me. It's affected me my entire life. Some things that needed to get done when I was a young boy didn't get done because we didn't have the money. So I've lived with this all my life. I get married. I don't want a divorce. That's the last thing in the world I want. I get married. It's for life. And but the wife, she doesn't have any experience with a divorce in her family. Her parents married their entire life, as far as I know, and she doesn't have a clue, but she wants a divorce. She doesn't try to work it out. We split up, and it had an effect on me again because I ended up losing everything. And I go into that in the book. I'm not going to go into it here, but I lost everything because of what happened during the divorce. So that's affected me from that point on. Oh, let me back up a minute with my grandmother. My grandmother was a bitch, senile bitch. My grandfather was a nice man. I'd like to have talked to him and get to know him a lot better than I did, but that didn't happen because my grandmother was the controlling matriarch of the family, and she did a horrible job, and it had an effect on me. So I got my mother, my grandmother, and my ex-wife all having an adverse effect on my being able to live my life. During the divorce, a young lady in her mid-20s falsely accuses me of following her and harassing her. It's all a lie. She was on the record, admitted a paranoid schizophrenic. But that didn't matter to the judge. He gives her a temporary restraining order. It separates me from my project, my building project I was involved with. I have to move out of my townhome. I go live in a trailer, in a travel trailer. I end up going to court. I document that in the book against her. I sue her parents and herself for what they falsely accused me. You can't win, folks, if you're a white male and you try to win in that legal system. Almost impossible. And anyway, so that had an effect on me. And then fast forward to another lady who provides me with some funds so that I can recover financially in 2010. And she ends up falsely accusing me of fraud. We end up going to court. I've mentioned this in other videos. I go into the legal system defending myself against false accusations. She's the one who's committed fraud, but I'm the one who ends up being found guilty. She gets a judgment against me. So that judgment has affected me ever since then. The business adventures, the business endeavors I was involved in fail because I'm devoting all my time trying to defend myself against false charges. And she even came after some of the products, the rocket stoves I had here at the local sporting goods store. So I shut down my website. I'm no longer producing the rocket stoves. I'm no longer producing, folks, because of this female who got a judgment against me, and it's accruing interest at $45 or $50 a day. So in my opinion, with my background, with my mother, my grandmother, my ex-wife, the crazy, schizoid, paranoid, schizophrenic female, and this what do you call a woman who can't understand English when you tell her you're not going to be able to be bought and she's got too much money to waste and the attorneys took her for probably $50,000 with her attorney's fees over a 3.5 year period of time. You know, and that's just too bad that you lost all that money, you bitch. So here I am doing a video on MGTOW. I think I'm qualified. All right. So let's talk about MGTOW, shall we? All right. MGTOW, men going their own way. Pretty popular here. It's pretty popular subject on the YouTube videos, and people, and there's men out there with several thousand subscribers and several thousand views, and I see one guy sitting there smoking a cigar, and he's got his supporters giving him money, and he's drinking the whiskey, and he's telling men what they want to hear, how they don't need women and they're going their own way. And now, he doesn't have a scriptural background. He's not coming from the point of view of scripture like I am. All right. That kind of attitude toward women, that we don't need women and we're not going to have anything to do with women and we're going to go our own way, is going to kill the white race, folks. It's going to harm the white race because men and women need each other. We need families. We need strong families. The family structure the family unit in the Western world is in a shambles for the most part. Divorce rate 50%, 70% of divorces initiated by the female because the just us, which does not include you if you're a white male, the just us legal system gets the women to get in and drag their husband into the legal system and then just destroys him. Just destroys his capacity to earn a living, destroys his wealth. And do we have to mention who started this? No fault, his fault, divorce. The Jewish women involved in this, folks. Do we have to go into that? Do we have to go? I'm not going to take the time, but that's who brought this all about. Women, the white women, the Caucasian women have been deceived. Women, you've been duped. Okay? Yeah, it feels good to take revenge, and yeah, you're vindictive, and yeah, you're going to get that husband. He took the best years of your life. But I'm not going to talk too much about you women other than the fact that you need to realize that what you're doing with the approbation of the court system, the legal system, is ruining the white race. It's ruining, it's bringing down, it's going to destroy, it is destroying the white race. And that's what our enemy, the Edomites and the Canaanites, Esau, Edomite enemy of ours, wants. And they're winning. So, to address you men, Scripture says that we are responsible. We are to take care of the women and children, our women and children of our race. Let's go have a look at that, Ephesians chapter 5, shall we? Here we are, Ephesians chapter 5. Let's look at verse 22. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. He is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be unto their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself, for no man ever hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth, even as the Lord the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband. Now, I'm not going to give a blow-by-blow exposition of that account there in Ephesians, but men, we're responsible for the women. We submit to Christ, Christ submits to God, the women submit to us, and yes, I know that's all messed up, but we can't just walk away from the women and just say, you know what, and give them the middle finger. We're responsible for them. Judeo-Christian churches, for the most part, that don't know how to teach and don't know how to teach the Word of God, don't know the truth from a hole in the wall, and that's why we're in the predicament we're in, because of these, quote, pastors. And not to make this a very long video, I'm going to have to end it there, just with the statement that we're responsible for our women. You know, you can blame and you can criticize the Muslims all you want, but they have control of their women. We've lost control of our women. The Caucasian men have lost, the Israelites have lost control of our women. And it's our responsibility. Yes, I understand. I have a background that understands why we have gone MGTOW, why we're going our own way. There's nobody, I don't think you could find a man out there who has more reason to go his own way. And I'll be quite honest with you, I don't want anything to do with females. I mean, I'd be crazy if I got in another relationship with a female, right? Okay, but that doesn't mean that we aren't responsible for our women. So be careful with all these men out there talking about MGTOW, going your own way, let the women open their own door, and let the women, you know, make it on their own and fend for themselves. That's exactly what our enemy wants. He wants us separated and going our own way. And I'm telling you, I understand, but we need to resist that if we're going to survive as a race and we're going to win this battle. I want to thank you for watching, thank you for subscribing, and thank you for supporting this channel. And may the grace of God, our Father, shed his unmerited favor upon us, our Father Yahweh, because we certainly need it. See you.